हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वी आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कसिंग द चैप्टर 22 केमिकल कोऑर्डिनेशन एंड इंटीग्रेशन एंड इन दिस कंसर्न वी हैव सीन द एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम, इट्स ग्लैंड्स, देयर नेम्स, फंक्शन एंड हार्मोन्स ऑफ हाइपोथैलेमस, हार्मोन सिक्रीटेड बाय द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड एंड देयर फंक्शंस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड एंड आफ्टर दैट वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड द फंक्शन एंड हार्मोन्स ऑफ पीनियल ग्लैंड, थायरॉइड ग्लैंड and parathyroid gland. Today we are here discussing the thymus gland. Okay, so the thymus gland, where it is located and what are its function, that we are to discuss today. And after that we will be discussing about the adrenal gland. So I have converted the whole topic of today's in the form of notes. So first we have to see the location of the thymus gland. That thymus gland is a lobular structure, shape structure, lobular structure is there. It is present between the lungs, behind the sternum, that is the chest bone, and ventral side of the aorta. This is the location of the thymus gland. After that, the hormones. Hormones secreted by the thymus gland are peptidal hormones, that means made up of protein, and exact name of the hormone is thymosine. Function. So this thymosine hormone actually plays its very important role in the differentiation of T lymphocytes, and which these T lymphocytes actually provides the immunity. What type of immunity? Cell mediated immunity. This is the type of immunity provided by T lymphocytes which get mature into thymus. This T word is actually for the thymus only. Now we are here coming to the next function of the thymus gland, that it also promotes the production of antibodies, and these antibodies provides another type of immunity which is called as humoral immunity. After that, if the thymus gland get degenerate, because it is very much functional in the young stage, but as the person grows, so in adults this thymus gland gets shrink and the formation of thymosin hormone also get decreases. As a result, the immune response of the old person become very weak because of the less production of thymosin hormone, because thymosin provides both the type of immunity to us, that is cell mediated immunity and humoral immunity. This is all about the thymus gland is given in your book. This is the name of the hormone. This is the function of the hormone, that it provides major role in the differentiation of T lymphocytes. It provides cell mediated immunity. It also provides humoral immunity. After that, we are here coming to the another gland. Another gland is adrenal gland. Adrenal gland is present number, first of all, the number of adrenal gland. They are one pair of adrenal gland is there, and their position is that location, that they are present on anterior part of the kidney. Suppose these are the two kidneys, so above the kidneys on the anterior part the adrenal glands are there. In your book it is shown here, this is one kidney above which the adrenal gland is there. Now it comes the structure of the adrenal gland. The tissue of the adrenal gland is further divided into adrenal medulla and adrenal cortex. This is adrenal cortex, which is the outside part, and internal part or inside centrally located part is called as adrenal medulla. In book also it is shown, this is adrenal medulla and outside part is adrenal cortex. Now we are here coming to the hormones secreted, because the medulla and cortex, both of them secrete different hormones. So first we are taking up here the hormone secreted by adrenal medulla. Adrenal medulla secretes two hormones, adrenaline, which is also called as epinephrine, and non-adrenaline, which is also called as norepinephrine. Both of them collectively called as catecholamines. Now the function. These adrenaline and non-adrenaline hormone actually secreted in response to stress, that means in the emergency situation the gland get stimulated and it starts secreting adrenaline and non-adrenaline hormone, so that these hormones are called as emergency hormones or fight or flight hormones. Okay, because they are secreted in the emergency condition. Now the effects of these hormones, which are catecholamines, which are secreted by adrenal cortex. So these hormones increase the alertness, pupillary dilations. These are secreted by adrenal medulla. These are secreted by adrenal medulla. They increase alertness, pupillary dilation, means in eye the pupils get dilated in emergency condition. Pyloerection, that means raising of hair, sweating, pasina aata hai, increase heart rate, strength of contraction of heart will increase, respiratory rate will increase, breakdown of glucose to glycogen to glucose for getting more and more energy in the emergency condition, more glucose is required. So glycogen will break down into glucose under the influence of these hormones, and it also stimulates the breakdown of lipids and proteins to provide more energy. So this is the function of hormones of adrenal medulla, that is adrenaline and non-adrenaline. Now we are here coming to the adrenal cortex. Adrenal cortex further can be divided into zona reticularis, inner layer, zona fasciculata, middle layer, zona glomerulosa, that is outer layer. Cortex has three layers. Now the hormones secreted by adrenal cortex are mainly called as corticoids. Now these corticoids are mainly two, glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. So glucocorticoids actually involved in the carbohydrate metabolism, and main glucocorticoid is cortisol. And mineralocorticoids, they are mainly responsible for regulation of water and electrolyte balance in the body, and main mineralocorticoid is aldosterone. Now we are here taking up the other function of glucocorticoids, that first of all it stimulates the gluconeogenesis. Gluconeogenesis means formation of glucose. Lipolysis means breakdown of lipid. Proteolysis means breakdown of protein. All of these processes, metabolisms are stimulated by glucocorticoids. Second function, it inhibits the cellular uptake of amino acids. Amino acids ke uptake ko reduce karta hai. Cortisol, which is the main glucocorticoids, also involved in cardiovascular system and in kidney function also. Glucocorticoids, the main cortisol, which is the main glucocorticoid, also produces anti-inflammatory reactions and suppresses the immune response. Our immune response is suppressed by glucocorticoids. Cortisol, it stimulates the RBC production also. These are the other function of glucocorticoids. Now we are here coming to the functions of mineralocorticoids, which is also called as aldosterone. Aldosterone, it stimulates the reabsorption of sodium and water and excretion of potassium and phosphate by the renal tubule. The function of aldosterone we have already discussed when we had discussed the excretory system and regulation by the kidney. Now aldosterone also helps in the maintenance of electrolytes, maintenance of body fluid volume, maintenance of osmotic pressure and maintenance of blood pressure. These are the functions of mineralocorticoids. Now the third hormone which is secreted by the adrenal cortex is androgenic steroids. These androgenic steroids are secreted in small amount. They are playing its role. Their role is there in the growth of axial hair, pubic hair and facial hair during the puberty. That means secondary sexual characteristics arise under the influence of these androgenic steroids. This is all is mentioned in your book here. These are the hormones of adrenal medulla, which are adrenaline, non-adrenaline, called as catecholamines, and their functions, they are called as emergency hormone. Then the adrenal cortex further divided into zona reticularis, fasciculata and glomerulosa. Its hormones are corticoids, glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids. The function of glucocorticoids are mentioned here. Functions of mineralocorticoid aldosterone is mentioned here. And the last hormone, androgenic steroids, functions are mentioned here. So we have discussed the topic up to here, which this all is only converted into the form of notes. through which we have discussed the topic. Thank you.